Hello students, this is my first lecture of strength of materials. So in this lecture, what we are going to discuss, so let's take our start and what is going to do in it. This is a strength of material subject and you are going to study in the third semester of civil engineering department, and its code in our university is CV201. So what we are going to study, so we will discuss in it, and this is done by Engineer Nahid Shahzad, and you can say Engineer Nahid Mushara. So what we have to do, how the course is divided, and how, what are the CLOs of this subject, what is the course outline. So let's have a start. What is this? This is the course outline. And course outline is consists of simple stress, introduction, analysis of internal forces, simple stress, shearing stress, bearing stress, thin walled pressure vessels. So in then next chapter is strain, and you can see stress strain diagram, Hooke's law, axial and shearing deformations, statically indeterminate member. So torsion, introduction, assumptions, derivation of torsion formula, longitudinal shearing stress, torsion of thin wall tubes, shear flow, helical spring. Shear and moments in beams, introduction, shear and moment, interpretation of vertical shear and bending moment, relation among load. Stresses in beams, derivation of flexural formula, analysis of flexural action. Then beam deflection, introduction, double integration method to determine slope and deflection in beams. And obviously it is going on the head of your, on the upper part of your head. Obviously these are very difficult terms. So when we will study, so it will be clear to all of you. So what is next? And the next one is the combined stresses, introduction, combined axial and flexural loads. Variation of stress with inclination of element, stress at a point, variation of stress at a point, analytical derivations. So what is next? Let's have course outline continued. Mohr circle, absolute maximum shearing stress. Application of Mohr circle to combined loadings. Columns, introduction, critical load, long columns by Euler's formula. Limitation of Euler's formula, intermediate columns, empirical formulas, eccentrically loaded columns. Moment of inertia, definition of moment of inertia, polar moment of inertia, radius of gyration, and all that. Then we are moving towards the next slide. And what is this? This is the course learning outcome on which basis we will analyze you or we will assist you. And it's mapping with program learning outcomes, PLOs, according to the Washington Accord. So what is this? First CLO 1, it comprises of solve internal forces, which is under general conditions of external forces. So there are the some topics from the course outline included in this CLO. So it is mapped with program learning outcome, that is engineering knowledge. And Bloom's taxonomy is C3, that is cognitive level 3 applying. So that's why I have selected the word solve over here. So let's mark over here, what is this? Let's have a look. Let me show you how I am going to show you what. So let's have a check. This one. And here you can see this word solve. I have taken for the C3 applying. Then the second course learning outcome, that is CLO2, interprets compatibility with equilibrium conditions to determine indeterminate and indeterminate problems, and that is mapped with the PLO2 problem analysis, and that is mapped with the Bloom's taxonomy, that is level 2 C2 understanding. Then we have CLO3, that is apply theory of elasticity to recognize the flexural stress distribution. And you can see over here in the CLO2, interprets I have taken from the Bloom's taxonomy C2. And then CLO3, apply. And apply I have taken from the C3, cognitive level 3, applying. So up CLO 3 is that apply theory of elasticity to recognize the flexural stress distribution on cross-section and behavior of bodies, and it is mapped with problem analysis and Bloom's taxonomy, C3. So you have to clear all these CLOs and you have to practice a lot. I will provide you each and everything related to these top CLOs and topics, and I will also provide you numerical problems in the form of videos, and you have to practice it. Then when you come in the class, so I will provide you numericals and you have to solve in the class. So in this way you will be able to study in online system, and then when you come in the physical class, so you have to perform the numericals over there. So I will mark you accordingly. So what is next? Relationship between assessment tools and CLOs. This is completely designed by myself. So this is the assessment tools. Quizzes comes from the CLO1, CLO2, CLO3. Obviously, assignment will also be on CLO1, CLO2, CLO3. All the CLOs will be assessed in different modes. For example, I will conduct quizzes in the class. I will provide you assignments on the VLE. You have to submit your assignments and you have to upload your assignments on the VLE software. Then you have midterm exams and then you have final exams. So you have lots of opportunities to gain marks in every CLO. So yours, every CLO should be more than 50%. Otherwise, you will be marked fail in the subject. So for the quizzes, 3 marks. Quiz number 1 will be from of 3 marks from CLO1. Quiz number 2 is of marks 4 and comes from CLO2. Then CLO3, you have quiz that is of marks 3. So in this way, you will cover 10 marks for the quizzes, 10 marks for the assignments, and 30 marks for the midterm exam, and final marks for the 50 marks. So this is the criteria of marking. You will get your marks accordingly, and you get 3 questions or maybe 6 questions of 10 marks of from each CLO. In the final exam, you will get CLO1. And this distribution can also be changed according to the midterm exam on the basis of your. When I evaluate it accordingly, so I will be the one who will decide it how marks will be distributed. So I will tell you accordingly. So you have to prepare all the topics during the semester and you have to be very well careful. So let's have a next slide. Grading policy. What will be the grading policy? According to the marks distribution, so assessment tools will be quizzes, assignments, midterm exam, final exam, and total. So quizzes of 10% means 10 of 10 marks, total of 100 marks. Huh? So assignments will be of 10 marks, midterm exam will be of 30 marks, final exam of 50 marks, and total marks will be 100%, means 100 marks. This is categorized into the percentage, and if you want to take it according to the marks distribution, So quizzes will be of 10 marks, assignments will be of 10 marks, midterm will be of 30 marks, final exam will be of 50 marks, and from total you will get 100. This is just these are the some recommended or reference books for the strength of material. So from which I will be making your lectures and numericals, you will get it from there. So if you have to see this, I will also provide on the VLE software as well. So recommended books will be Strength of Material, 4th edition by Andrew Pytel and Ferdinand Singer. This book is famous from the name of Singer. The reference books will be Mechanics of Materials, Mechanics of Materials from Nelson Thorns, and Hibbler, R.C. Hibbler, Mechanics of Materials, New Jersey. So these are some recommended books. So you want to purchase it, you want to download it, so you can do it. So these are some recommended books and reference books. So let's move to the next slide. And now let's have a start. What is concrete? And you can see the diagram picture of what is moving over there. That is concrete mixer. But the question is that what is concrete? We don't know about what is concrete. So let's have a start. what is concrete? You can see concrete is mixing in the picture. So concrete is a composite material composed of fine and coarse aggregate. So concrete is a composite material. So what are the composite materials included in it? Fine aggregate is the sand, and coarse aggregate is what? Is the coarser particles, you can say particles of stones, or you can also say the particles, small particles of rocks. Bonded together with absolute cement, we have to combine it with the cement. Cement acts as a bonding agent, or you can say binding agent, that hardens cures over time. So when you put it for the curing and then dry it, so it will get strong and it will get hardens. So how is it so? So we will do a test in the laboratory. So you will understand how we have to make concrete. So next is what? The cement reacts with the water. When we add water in that, so the cement reacts with the water and other ingredients to form a hard matrix that binds the materials together into a durable stone-like material that has many uses. So obviously concrete used in the building structure, and you all know that what is that. So let's move to the next slide. Hopefully concrete is clear to all of you. So these are some types of concrete. What are the types of concrete? No, not at all. Sorry. These are some types of cement. So cement has many types, and according to the use, their laborers or contractors has to use the cement. So first one is the ordinary Portland cement, which one is commonly used throughout the country, and that is OPC, ordinary Portland cement. And OPC also comes in different grading criteria, that is 33 grade, 43 grade, and 53 grade. So next one is the rapid hardening cement, sulfate resisting cement, air entraining cement, colored cement, high alumina cement, blast furnace slag cement, low heat cement, Portland pozzolana cement, PPC, oil well cement, masonry cement, quick setting time cement. So these are different types of cements which will be used according to the usage, or for example, which type of construction is going to be done. So which type of cement is to be used. So accordingly, actually these are different types of cement on the basis of chemical reactions. So some cement, there is different criteria of composition of chemical materials. So it is completely depend upon the chemical reactions. So on this, that basis, cement is categorized, and you must study this in the engineering materials. Sorry for the inconvenience. Actually, I am suffering from severe cough, so that's why it is quite difficult for me to speak for more than 10 minutes. So no issue. Let's have a start. So that's why I paused the recording. And now you can see these are the different criterias or different types or categories of the cement. So let's move on the next slide and what is going to, we are going to study. So what is this? Common applications of cement. And you all know that what is the cement and why we are going to use cement. So in building, cement uses in building floors, roofing, columns, beams, piles, bricks, mortar, and plaster, etc. Transportation, roads, pathways, crossing, bridges, tunnels, parking, sleepers, and runways, etc. Water is used, for the water, for the passage of water, for to the flow of water. Cement also used. So what is this? Pipes, culverts, drains, canals, dams, weirs, reservoir, tanks, and pools, etc. Then we have civil, piers, docks, retaining wall, and breast wall, etc. So let's move on to the next slide and what is we are going to study. And what is this? Properties of the cement. Physical properties and chemical properties. So physical properties of the cement includes consistency, setting time, initial or final setting time, soundness, fineness, compressive strength, heat of hydration, specific gravity. In chemical properties include tricalcium aluminate C3A, tricalcium silicate C3S, कैल्शियम सिलिकेट, फेराइट सी फोर ए एफ, मैग्नीशिया एम जी ओ, ऑक्साइड सल्फर ट्राइऑक्साइड, आयरन ऑक्साइड, अल्कलीज, फ्री लाइम, एलुमिना. सो दीज आर द केमिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑन विच बेसिस सीमेंट इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड और कैटेगराइज इन टू डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज. So these are the physical properties we will test in the strength of material laboratory. So hopefully you will learn it over there a lot. So the next slide is what desired properties of fresh concrete. So we have to test the concrete. So on what basis we have to test the concrete? So first is the consistency, workability, segregation, and we also have to check these properties for the cement as well. So consistency is the fluidity or degree of wetness of concrete. You can also say consistency is the fluidity or degree of wetness of cement as well. It is a major factor indicating the workability of freshly mixed concrete. What we have to do, we have to consistency is what. For example, if you are going to take an example of a human. For example, if there is an employee and he is working in an office, and his boss says that he is very inconsistent. So why is it so? Actually, he is not concentrating on the single subject. He is working on the one task, single task. And then he left it in the mid of that because he finds it boring and he will move on the other topic or other task. Or you can also say if someone is very inconsistent in his job, so what does it mean by that? For example, he is switching jobs on the basis of 2 months. After every 2 months, he switches jobs. So he will not be able to learn a lot. So consistency is what if an employee is working on us in his company for 10 to 15 years, so what, or 5 years, 6 years, so it means that he is consistent in his work. So the next same goes with the concrete and cement. For example, if you will add water in the cement, so what does it mean by that? How much amount of water you added in the cement? For example, if you add so much water in that, so obviously the cement will get started to flow. And if you will add less amount of water, so it will get dry. So what you have to do, you have to take average amount of water that is desired to achieve its consistency. So we have to check it, and we have different variety of apparatus to check this consistency. And hope we will do it in the laboratory as well. We will practice, we will perform the experiment on this consistency. Then we have workability. It is desirable that freshly mixed concrete be relatively easy to transport, place, compact, and finish without harmful segregation. What is segregation? Means there will be no cement comes out from that. A concrete mix satisfying these conditions said to be workable. What does it mean by that? Concrete should be mixed properly and it is easily transported into the same condition. For example, in the concrete mixer, easily placed over there, compacted and finished without harmful segregation. That is called workability. And what is segregation? Segregation refers to a separation of the components of fresh concrete. For example, cement comes out from the concrete or water comes out from the concrete, resulting in a non-uniform mix. So it means that if concrete is not properly mixed, so what will happen? It will get dry and the concrete or block, whatever you are going to make it, so it will not be in uniform mix. So the primary cause for this is difference in the size of constituents of concrete. So what does it, we have to take proper mix design, otherwise it will make a issue. Moreover, improper mixing, placing, consolidation also lead to segregation. So these are the three terms or the properties of the fresh concrete on which basis we have to decide it whether the construction is going to be done better or is not going to be done better. So these are all about the definition of the consistency, workability, and segregation. Hopefully you will get my point. If you have any query, just write it down in your notebook and bring into the class and ask me in the class. So Let's have a next slide, and that is soundness of cement. So we have discussed three properties, physical properties of the concrete. Now we are going to discuss about the soundness of cement. What is soundness of cement? Refers to the ability of cement. Soundness, you can also check for the cement, obviously. Soundness of cement refers to the ability of the cement to not undergo any appreciable change in volume of cement. So why is it so? Sorry for this. Soundness of cement, what does it mean by that? You have to fill the mold. You have to mix cement with water and you have to fill the mold. Then you have to put that leach apparatus into the water. And on the next day, you have to check it, how much swelling occurred in that, how much change in the volume occurred in that cement. So that is the soundness of cement. So that there is a limit for the good cement, for the good quality of cement, that it that extent it is not to be changed, means there is some length or volume is provided, that it this amount should according to that limit it is to be changed. If not, and if gets greater than that, so it means soundness of cement does not work it. So that cement is not feasible to use in the construction. So these are the some ways or criteria on which basis we have to decide the properties or the quality of the cement or the concrete. And we will perform different variety of experiments on this in the strength of material laboratory. So it will be clear to all of you that how these experiments will be performed and how the consistency, soundness, initial or final setting time of cement will be checked in the laboratory and why we are doing so. So these are the some things. One more thing I want to tell you here is that whenever we are using cement, so we have to do dry sieving. What is the sieving? What in sieving we have to sieve it, so the dust particles which comes out and the cement remains in the sieve. So we will use it for the testing purposes, or we can use it in the construction as well. So there are a variety of practicals we will perform in the laboratory, and it will be clear to all of you how these properties will go on. So let's have a next slide, and what is going over here. And this is the time to say you thank you and say goodbye to all of you. But after watching this video, if you find it helpful, so comment in the chat box and in the comment section of your YouTube, on my YouTube channel, and must subscribe my channel, and don't forget to subscribe my channel, and don't forget to click on the bell notification. In this way, you will be able to get more variety of videos, and that will be helpful for you for your education. And don't forget to follow my blog, that is www.nahidshizad.blogspot.com. So you must follow it, so you will get lots of blogs over there related to civil engineering and related to the problems and issues in our environment or in our country, and how can we resolve it. And I also want all from you guys that you have to input your recommendations, your mitigation measures over there. So in this way, it will be helpful for me to learn from you, and obviously you will learn from me. So I believe that education or learning will not get stopped. Obviously, as a teacher, I always love to learn from my students. So your comments and feedbacks are the strength of my channel. So don't forget to subscribe and comment in the chat box or the comment box. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.